So there's a lot of trends in the Silicon Valley. Should I, as an entrepreneur, look for an idea around a trend?
Again, I think it depends. There's a lot of people who can be very kind of like trend-centric. You know, social, mobile, local is hot, so let's all go chase that. Or everybody wants to, I mean, I don't know how many companies I've heard about shared economy. You know, back in 2000s, there was this wave about pets. So I think that there's a lot of this, I hate to use the word herd mentality, everybody wants to go do the same thing. But having said that, I think it's valuable to look at current disruptions, current dislocations, like, for example, mobile. Having a camera on the mobile phone or having your location on the mobile phone, you know, it's created businesses around like Uber or Instagram. I mean, these are really mobile-first companies, and this wasn't possible 6, 7, 8 years ago. So I think studying, you know, hey, there is this big movement from landlines to mobile, I think people can consciously think about downstream impacts of those things, and businesses then can be created. Music is another great example. You know, music has been massively disrupted, you know, around how do you produce it, how do you distribute it, and out of that have come companies like Spotify or even device makers, you know, iPods and phones and so on. So I think there's a lot of benefit in thinking about disruptions and what does that mean 3 years from now, 6 years from now. Cloud is a great example, right? AWS started doing cloud, and now there are numerous companies that got created around that trend, security, payments, and so on. So I think it's valuable, but having said that, I don't want to just recommend that as the only approach. You know, we can see companies that are created in retail, in agriculture, in insurance, in data, and so on. So just old-fashioned industries that people are not looking at, but there's a lot of opportunity because, you know, incumbents populate those, and it's not the sexy thing to do, but you can definitely create businesses there.
So as an entrepreneur, how should I think about competition, and how should it impact my product?
I think it's very important to be aware of the competition, but I think it also depends on the stage of the company. I've seen entrepreneurs who get very distracted by trying to follow and copy every move of their competition. And I think it's not very healthy, especially if you're trying to go after a new market, if you're creating a new category, you let somebody else define your moves and your product, and that's not healthy. But I think as you start maturing and as you start optimizing, it's useful to think about, you know, even small differences in the product can create massive differences in the mindset of consumers. So I think if you were to simplify it, if you're just getting going, if you're in a new category, don't let the customer define, don't let the competition define you. But if you're mature, I think you need to pay more attention to the competition.